Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss module in Python. In my last video, I discussed about function. Okay, let's see. What is the problem in function? One problem with entering function interactively at the Python prompt like this is that the definition go away when we quit the Python. If we want to use them again, the next time we have to type them all over again. Programs are usually created by typing definitions into a separate file called a module or script. This file is saved on the disk so that it can be used over and over again. How to create module? A module file is just a text file, and you can create one using any program for editing text like Notepad or word processor program. What is programming environment? A special type of program known as a programming environment simplifies the process. A programming environment is specifically designed to help the programmers write programs and includes features such as automatic indenting, color highlighting, and interactive development. What is IDLE? The standard Python distribution includes a programming environment called IDLE, Integrated Development and Learning Environment, that you my use for working on program here that you may use for working on program here. Let's see what is chaos. Let's illustrate the use of a module file by writing and running a complete program. Our program will illustrate a mathematical concept known as chaos. Here, this is our program. Let's see, this is our module. First one should be saved with the name chaos.py. The .py is extension indicates that this file is a Python module. Ash is used to put comment. def is keyword makes the definition of main. You can see that this particular example contains lines to define a new function called main. Print is the keyword to print on screen. X is equal to input, open and close parenthesis, is the input statement. For is the looping statement. We are looping here 1 to 7. X is variable used to store output. What we are getting from this mathematical chaos? Print X is to print X value in the output screen. Last statement, main. It is called to invoke the function again. This is our output. Import chaos, then this is the statement what we are getting from print statement. This is statement also from input statement. We are inputting x value dot 5. Next, after that the calculation. From calculation we are getting this line. X value is 0.5. We have to initiate this here. 3.9 into 0.5, x value is 0.5 into 1 minus x value 0.5. Then after that execution of this statement, we are getting the first number. Again it repeats second line. To get this line, for loop will go, then our x value is 0.975. we are getting from this function. 3.9 into x value now 0.975 into 1 minus 0.975, close the bracket, then after we are getting the second line. Like this is going on 7 times. To get this output, what we have to do? Let's see. This program can be run in number of different ways that depend on the actual operating system and programming environment that you are using. In Windows, by clicking on the module files icon, in command line, type command like python chaos.py. In ideally, by opening in the editor and then selecting a command like import, run or execute. When you first import a module file in this way, Python creates a companion file with a .pyc extension. In this example, Python creates another file on the disk called chaos.pyc. This is an intermediate file used by the Python interpreter. A module needs to be imported into a session only once. After the module has been loaded, we can run the program again by asking the Python to execute the main command. We do this by using the special dot notation. Typing chaos.main tells the Python to invoke the main function in the chaos module. Thank you.